It was in this ruined castle, once a royal residence, that a prince locked up his own brother for 20 years. I'll tell you who he was and where I am in just a moment. House Hunter has her daughter in tow to help look for a new country home that suits her exacting needs. We're going all out on character.
I do like the beams on the ceiling, and the ceiling is so low. Look at that. I can actually touch it.
Yeah.
And there's nothing average about the views on offer too.
Wow. Look at that view. That's stunning, isn't it?
That is amazing.
Today I'm in North Wales, and this is what remains of the early 13th century Dolbarden Castle, built by the Welsh prince Llywelyn the Great. After his death, his grandson, Llywelyn the Last, imprisoned his own brother in the tower for more than two decades. That story is said to have inspired the work of the landscape artist J.M.W. Turner, who made several sketches of the castle in the late 1700s. And it's no wonder, set against the dramatic backdrop of Snowdonia's mountains, it's considered one of the finest of North Wales's many treasures. Of the six counties that make up North Wales, Gwynedd and Conwy to the west are the two we're exploring today. The area's star attraction is Snowdonia National Park. Here, surrounded by forest, lies the village of Battersea Coed, which has been a resting place for travellers since the 17th century. Protected by its national park status, the village's Victorian architecture is unspoilt, giving it a charm that continues to appeal to today's tourists. Carving through the hills and mountains, the Welsh Highland Railway is the UK's longest heritage line, which runs for 25 miles from Porthmadog to Carnarvon. The historic steam engines provide an opportunity to appreciate Mount Snowdon and its surrounds in comfort. But the region's gems aren't limited to Snowdonia. On the rocky estuary of the River Conwy stands the ruins of one of North Wales's best preserved fortifications. Built in the 13th century, Conwy Castle has 21 towers, three gatehouses, and walls that stretch almost a mile in length. The stunning landscapes and rich history found in Wales's northern counties have a lot to offer those who seek to swap their urban lives in towns and cities for a more rural and peaceful existence. The average cost of a detached property across the six counties that make up North Wales is just under £210,000. That's a healthy £130,000 below the combined figure for England and Wales. Now, Flintshire and Wrexham in the east of the region have great transport links to the likes of Liverpool and Manchester, so there is a bit of a premium to be paid there. But those coastal areas in the west around Conwy, Gwynedd and Anglesey offer great value, and those fabulous views, music to the ears of today's house buyer who's hoping to follow in the footsteps of her daughter. Julia currently lives in the Berkshire town of Windsor in the three-bedroom house she bought 14 years ago.
The house I live in at the moment is lovely, and I'll be sad to leave it. I like the fact that it's quite light and airy and that it's surrounded by greenery. It feels a little bit more secluded than other houses in the town.
Living and working in the area has been ideal for Julia, but it no longer offers the lifestyle that she desires.
Windsor's lovely. It's a very busy, bustling town, obviously attracts a lot of tourists. I think I would like somewhere quieter, somewhere with more space, somewhere with fresh air and views rather than shops and endless cafes. I would just like to be somewhere more open, more close to nature. We have foxes, we have hedgehogs, we have frogs in the garden, which is lovely, but I think just being really up and close to it would be much better.
Until 3 years ago, Julia shared her home with her daughter Victoria, who flew the nest and made her own rural escape.
I've had some really nice times since I've moved to Wales, yeah. There's so much to explore up there. There's so much history as well, castles and all sorts. You could literally just take yourself off for a day, just go walking somewhere and discover something new, which I absolutely love about it.
Although Julia spent many childhood holidays in the region, it's her daughter's relocation that's prompted her to make the move herself.
It's only really since Victoria's lived there and I've visited her in North Wales that I have seen the absolute wonder of it. It's such a beautiful, beautiful place. It's just lovely, lovely place to be.
Julia has been a nurse for 25 years, but she isn't looking to retire just yet. She hopes the move will bring new opportunities and the chance to redress her work-life balance.
I would love to do some more study. Something with animals would interest me, wildlife. I would like to get into cycling again. I used to cycle, not for quite a while. It's not quite as nice to cycle in the town as it is in the countryside. And I quite fancy taking up kayaking.
Yeah.
Together.
Let's do kayaking.
The upcoming Welsh move is one that can't come quick enough for Julia.
I just think it's time now for me to have an adventure. It's been a long time since I've had an adventure.
Julia's keen to find a new house that's no more than 30 minutes from Victoria's home in Penmyn Mawr, so we'll be concentrating our house search on the western counties of Gwynedd and Conwy. I'm meeting up with mother and daughter Julia and Victoria to begin our house hunting tour of this stunning region.
Julia and Victoria, welcome to North Wales.
Thank you.
What attracts you to this part of the country?
I think the countryside, the peace and quiet, the easy access to all the things that I love, which is the beach and the countryside. And as Victoria's already here, she's pioneered the way for me.
I love the fact that you escaped to the country first.
I did escape first, yeah, a couple of years ago. And I think, you know, Mum's been up to see me quite a few times. And each time she comes, she just falls more in love with North Wales.
What would you like from the property itself?
I would like to find a character property, somewhere that's not just a box with several different size, you know, box rooms inside.
You want to feel like you are in the country?
Absolutely, absolutely. Not looking out with a neighbour here, neighbour there, more looking out the back window onto fields or a sea view or the mountains in the distance.
But you don't want to be too isolated, do you?
No, I wouldn't want to be 3 miles from the nearest neighbour or shop or what have you, and obviously reasonably close to Victoria.
Talk me through the inside of the house. How many bedrooms do you want?
I would like 2 to 3, a minimum of 2. Lovely big kitchen, lovely big bathroom, lovely big main bedroom, and a lovely big lounge would be nice as well.
And you're into your gardening?
I do enjoy gardening, and I enjoy having the outside space. So I think anywhere with no garden, no outside space would be a no-no for me.
And the great news is you are ready to move because you've already sold your house.
Indeed, yes, just from last week. I have a buyer for my house and we've agreed an offer, so I'm in a good position.
Remind me of your budget?
My budget is £290,000, £295,000.
Well, we've got 3 lovely properties already lined up.
Marvellous.
Fingers crossed, one of them suits. Let's go.
Good, thank you.
For her budget of £295,000, Julia is looking for a property that has plenty of character with 2 to 3 bedrooms. It must have a garden with lovely rural views and be close to her daughter Victoria. We have a great range of properties for Julia to visit, but I will only reveal the price at the end of each tour. The final property will be our mystery house, which offers plenty of Welsh charm if Julia is willing to venture into the wild.
Victoria, when Mum has come to visit you, have you begun to see how at home she feels here?
Oh, yeah, definitely, yeah. Especially when we go out to the beach and things like that. Anglesey especially. There's wild ponies around here.
Basically everything I love would
be on your doorstep.
Even just this drive, I think this area sells itself, doesn't
yeah.
it?
It's lovely.
It's peace and quiet that Julia seeks in her house move to North Wales, so we're starting our search in the village of Abergwyn Gregan. From here, it's 3 miles to the Menai Strait, a channel carved by glaciers 20,000 years ago, separating Anglesey from mainland Wales. The closest amenities are a 10-minute drive away in Llanfairpwll. The town provides a post office, several pubs, a cafe, and a range of shops. Ideally located just a 15-minute drive away from daughter Victoria, our first property is nestled into a hillside on the edge of the village. Welcome to house number one.
It's lovely. It does look amazing, actually. The setting is gorgeous.
Yeah.
The house itself officially dates to the 19th century, but everyone locally thinks it could be the 1600s. There's no official record of how far it dates back.
Yes. Well, it's certainly very traditional.
It is. It's really nice on the outside.
Mm. I love the way that it's tucked in, and it looks, it's traditional, and it's obviously quite old without being ramshackle. It looks tidy, it looks well-maintained.
Shall we head on in?
Shall we?
Yeah.
Yes, please.
Julia certainly seems charmed by the location and exterior character of this former farm worker's cottage. I'm hoping this property will continue to impress indoors.
So this door comes straight into the kitchen.
Okay. Well, it's
nice.
Not a bad-sized kitchen, is it?
No.
Quite long and narrow, but it's not tiny, it's not too boxy.
The house is not standard by any means because of the history of it. The bit that's the dining room was the pen for the animals.
Right.
They think this was the creamery.
OK. Oh, wow.
So, obviously, it wasn't built to be a house, a standard house,
yeah,
by any means, and you didn't want standard, did
Absolutely
you?
Absolutely not, no. No, I like it. I like it because it's not, it, like you say, it doesn't conform to what you'd expect.
The usual layout.
From a house, which is what I like. I like finding unusual.
You've got your wooden beams.
Yeah, got the beams.
I'm glad you like beams. There's plenty of them through here.
Fantastic.
Here is your country cottage living room.
Very nice. I do like the beams on the ceiling, and the ceiling is so low. Look at that. I can actually touch it.
Yeah.
And the fireplace has all been restored, so it's a working wood burner.
Yeah. That's nice. Wow, that is nice. Yeah, that's lovely.
Now, this is really the middle of the house, and the couple that live here at the moment live on this level.
The ground floor of the property also benefits from a family bathroom and what's currently designated as the master bedroom. Upstairs on the first floor, there are two double bedrooms built into the eaves. Back downstairs, we find the master.
This is quite a good size.
You can see why they use it as the master.
It's spacious enough so that you can get either side of the bed. You've got room for your bedroom furniture.
It's a good
and
size,
another
actually.
Lovely little window there. Mm. Again, showing the character of the house, the width of the walls.
I'm kind of blown away, in a way. I can't get over how thick the walls are.
Mm.
It's ticked so many boxes so far.
Mm. I think we should head on outside and really have a look around at how much space you
that
have.
That would be lovely, okay. Thank you.
To the front of the property is a gravelled parking area, a neat patio with scenic rural views. It's hard to tell where the garden ends and the countryside begins.
Julia, you wanted a big garden. You've got 3/4 of an acre here.
It's a lovely garden. I have to say, it's a lovely, lovely outside space.
How much would you have to pay for it, though?
I would say it's absolutely at the top of the budget. Definitely 295, 300,000, I would think.
I was thinking around the 280 mark.
It's actually on, though, for £245,000.
Wow. No. Oh, wow. Absolutely amazing. And the attractiveness, although it was there already, has just
it's
gone up
a little
about,
bit, yeah.
Yeah, 200%.
Take your time, have another look around, explore the areas you might not have seen, and then come and find me.
Yeah, okay. Absolutely.
Okay.
Thank you.
Coming in at £50,000 under Julia's maximum budget, this stone cottage provides the 3 bedrooms, living areas and character on her property wish list. Set in an exquisite location with views all around, it lies just a 15-minute drive from Victoria.
Let's have a look. Oh, look, look at that window.
Oh, wow.
That's amazing. Oh, and the sea view.
Yeah.
Fantastic. What a lovely little space.
Yeah.
I love it. I'm really happy with it. And this is perfect. It's in lovely condition. Beautiful locations, you know, snuggled into the hillside.
I could see her living in this property, definitely. She's one of these people I could see ideas ticking around in her head already about what she would do with certain things. The price was a massive shock. It's made it a bit more appealing, I think, to her.
I was very surprised that I was so way out with the price, given that there's so much land and that it is such a lovely property. If there were little tweaks that I wanted to make, then I can probably afford to do that.
Well, that was a lovely start to our
It was a very good hunt. Start. An excellent start. Very happy.
And we have another one to see today.
I know.
Renowned for its mountains, rolling hills and rugged coast, North Wales's beautiful and varied landscape is a wonder to behold and the perfect backdrop for an adventure. The area has recently been hailed as the fourth best place in the world for outdoor activities. Julia can't wait to have all these opportunities on her doorstep, and she'd love to learn to sea kayak when she moves. So today, they're having an introductory lesson on a lake with instructor Roger Chandler.
We are both new to kayaking, Roger. What makes this lake so perfect for beginners like us?
So the beautiful thing about the lake is generally we can find little areas that are out of the wind. The swell, what we can hear here, is actually quite small, but we've got no currents. So we've removed one of the aspects that can initially make sea kayaking a little bit puzzling.
Today's lesson is taking place on one of Wales's largest lakes, Llyn Padarn.
Okay.
Located at the edge of the Snowdonia National Park, it offers sailing, rowing and stand-up paddleboarding. Land lovers are also well accommodated here, with walking paths and even a train tour around the lake, which runs restored steam engines from local slate quarries. And for the novice kayaker, the first thing to master is getting in.
Fabulous. And then just make sure that backrest is up.
Yeah.
Ready? Easy.
Go in.
And remember, gentle movements.
Yeah.
Oh, dear.
Yeah, if you want to begin to gently go backwards while your mum gets in, so as you're doing there, just use the back of the blade. Get her just working this area around here and just get a feeling for control of the boat's fire, the paddle. So our forward stroke is close to the boat and a turning stroke is much broader. It's out from the edge of the boat. That's it. And then do one on the other side as well.
Once they're in the water, there's no stopping Julia and Victoria.
So we're going to make our way through this lovely little Everglade.
With over 45 lakes, rivers and canals, North Wales has plenty of locations for Julia to explore as she builds up her confidence. If she decides to pursue the activity seriously, a new kayak will cost upwards of £500.
It's absolutely gorgeous in here.
Yeah.
This little gladey bit, you can see right down to the bottom. Absolutely lovely.
Kayaking dates back thousands of years when they were used by the indigenous people of Greenland for hunting and fishing. It was introduced as an Olympic sport in 1936, but the advent of plastic kayaks in the 1980s made it more versatile, and it's increased in popularity ever since.
OK, so how's it going?
Brilliantly. I'm loving it, loving every minute.
Yeah, it's really good. I'm enjoying it.
Fantastic.
It's so peaceful, and exploring all these little nooks and crannies out from the lake is just lovely.
It
and
really
the
adds.
It's so clear.
It really adds to it, having the texture and this area we call the lagoons.
Yeah.
You can move in and out of. Mm. So rather than it just being a shoreline, you know, it feels like you're in the Everglades. You're actually exploring.
Yeah,
it does.
And it's perfect for inexperienced kayakers because it's so calm and tranquil and it's not too much of a challenge to begin with, but it's lovely, I'm loving it.
Today's kayaking experience has given Julia a different view on the place she soon hopes to call home. And she's taken to it like a duck to water. Getting back to our house search, the second property will take Julia further inland to the Conwy village of Treffrew. At the edge of Snowdonia National Park, this popular village has a post office, traditional butchers, two pubs, and a popular restaurant. The house we're here to see is centrally located within the village and commands a prominent position up on a hillside overlooking the Conwy Valley.
That is why I brought you to this side of the house. It's not bad, is it?
No, it's gorgeous.
How do you feel about being in a village?
I think I'd be quite happy to be in a village, especially where, you know, you're not looking out onto another road or rows of houses. It doesn't feel like being in the centre of a busy village, which it obviously is.
And the house itself, what do you think about the exterior?
Again, I mean, it looks beautifully maintained. Although it's an old house, it's lovely. It's absolutely pristine. Mm. And I like the little features there above the windows. That's really interesting. I'll be, interested to have a look inside it.
Commanding impressive views over the Conwy Valley, this Victorian detached house was built from stone quarried in the hillside below the property and topped, of course, with Welsh slate.
Come in. As you can see, the current owners use this as a dining room, but actually, you could use this as a little snug, couldn't you, with the fireplace?
Yes, definitely. It's quite a focal point, isn't it, there?
This used to be the kitchen, and that's why there's a utility there.
Okay.
Because the kitchen at the moment is an extension.
Okay. Oh, wow. Wow. That's a fabulous kitchen.
That's really nice.
Wow. Look at that view. That's stunning, isn't it?
That is amazing. Mm. There's no need to look at what the kitchen looks like.
I've forgotten about that. But no, the kitchen is amazing as well.
The kitchen is lovely. I love the tiles on the floor. Nice for entertaining, but you don't have to bob in and out of the kitchen. I can see people gathering here.
Yeah.
Like it being the hub, really. And that's just so peaceful with the flowers in front and then that view behind.
Let's go and look at the rest of the downstairs while you ponder. Please.
Wow. Very spacious. And the views again. It's a lovely space. For me, this is less interesting as a room, even though it, you know, you've got the space and you've got the views. The room that we came into, where you had the old kitchen, that was full of character and quirky and very sweet. And then you come into a slightly more ordinary, as I say, no less lovely, because this couldn't be called ordinary when you're looking out onto that view. But it is a slightly more ordinary room.
Victoria, what do you think?
I kind of like it. It's a really nice space. It's light. And I think possibly you're looking at it as it is now and not how you could make it.
Yeah, possibly.
Should we head on upstairs?
Shall we? Yeah.
Julia seems to be struggling to see the full potential of this more conventional house, but there are more cosy features upstairs, with three double bedrooms and a shower room with separate WC.
Here we have the master.
Wow.
Ooh. This is a good size, isn't it?
What are you thinking? A bit more character up here?
A bit more character up here, and I think with the wood as well, with the way the cupboards come over the top of the bed, with the lights underneath, that's quite sweet.
Should we head outside? Spoil ourselves with the view again? And you can start to think about how much this house might be on the market for.
Okay.
Turning our attention back to the well-established garden, there are two outdoor seating areas perfectly placed to enjoy the far-reaching panorama. But those beautiful views do come with a slight compromise. So I know it might feel like you don't have a huge amount of garden, but actually you've got a third of an acre.
Really?
It's all the way down the slope.
Oh my gosh.
See that gate over there?
Yes.
That is your gate.
Oh wow.
And there are 72 steps down to your gate.
Wow. It's half a hillside.
So if you wanted to walk straight to the village, you really, really could.
Yes.
Do you think you could manage a garden like that?
I'm probably sure I could. I'm a good excuse to have to wander down into the village.
Should we talk about price?
I do think this one is definitely top of budget. Definitely nearer the 290, 295 mark.
I'm going to go 275.
It's on the market for 274,950.
Oh, wow. Oh, well done. Mm. The value for money is astounding that you can have all of this in this location. It's, quite astonishing, really.
Mm. Well, the garden is vast.
It's huge.
There's a lot to explore.
Yes.
Head on down.
Let's
have a look at whether it's something you could manage.
Thank you.
And I'll come and find you.
Just over £20,000 under budget, this Victorian property has a classic layout that offers spacious living areas and the three requested bedrooms. Boasting outstanding views over the Conwy Valley, the house is also less than half an hour away from Julia's daughter Victoria.
Property 2 is very lovely. It's certainly in a beautiful location. The kitchen is stunning and it does have some lovely features, as well as being spacious and, of course, all this lovely land.
I really like this house. I really like the location. The views are amazing. It's within walking distance of the village, shops, pub.
It feels slightly to me more of a house that I would move into as a couple rather than on my own.
How's your mum?
She's okay. I think she's got a lot to think about.
We have given you a lot to think about, haven't we?
You have. You've put me in quite a quandary.
Glass of wine?
I think so.
Let's go.
We're exploring the countryside of North Wales to find Julia from Berkshire a home with the great outdoors on its doorstep. With her Windsor house now sold and accompanied by her daughter Victoria, she's looking to spend £295,000 on a charming rural home. Still to come, some traditional and distracting character features in the mystery house.
Yeah, I'm speechless. That is absolutely stunning. It's huge.
And the room itself is a good size, isn't it?
It's massive.
No, the room's really nice as well, actually.
And I pick up the pace and discover how old Welsh quarries are being transformed.
This is amazing!
Yesterday was certainly productive. We showed Julia two cottages that were fairly different in terms of style and location, and we could see how much she felt at home in that more rural setting of house number one. Now, with that in mind, today's mystery house is going to offer Julia the full Escape to North Wales experience. In today's mystery house, we're heading deeper into North Wales to the rural village of Carmel, which at a 40-minute drive is the furthest location from daughter Victoria. This hilltop village could be a postcard for North Wales, with quaint cottages set against a backdrop of rolling green and rugged slate hills, a memento of the area's industrial heritage. From this elevated point, the village possesses far-reaching vistas over Carnarvon Bay and Anglesey, which can also be appreciated in all their glory from our final property. Welcome to the mystery house.
Wow.
Wow.
Yesterday we noticed how you loved being in that rural setting.
Yes.
How's 2 acres for you?
2 acres?
Oh my gosh.
Oh wow.
Everything you see around the house belongs to the house. 7 paddocks plus a garden.
Oh my gosh.
That's astounding.
And you don't have to maintain all of this yourself, because actually they get the local farmer to put his ram in, and then the ram just take care of the horse.
Oh, wow.
Brilliant.
So
no ride-on mower then?
No, there's not a lot of maintenance for the 2 acres, really. What about the house itself?
The house itself looks a really good size, and I love that it's tucked away into the hill. It looks very, very pretty, and I would imagine fairly spacious looking at it from here.
Yeah, it does look like it's going to be quite big inside.
Mm.
It does look really nice from the outside as well.
It does.
Yeah.
You up for looking inside?
Oh, absolutely.
Definitely. Should we do it?
Yes, yeah. Please.
Let's head on down.
It's fair to say that North Wales is proving to be a place that delivers when it comes to location. And I'm really keen to see what Julia will make of our mystery offering. This, a single-storey 18th century former cowshed.
Come in.
Look at the walls again.
I know. I think they're even thicker than the first house.
Which is something you quite liked, thick walls.
Absolutely.
And you will have noticed as we came in, there was a utility boot room.
Yes. This is a lovely kitchen, really beautiful. They've still kept it fairly in keeping with the age of the house, but it all looks beautifully clean and again, fresh.
From the kitchen, it's a few steps to the living room.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, I'm speechless. That is absolutely stunning. It's huge.
And the room itself is
a good size,
isn't it?
It's massive.
Yeah, no, the room's really nice as well, actually.
It just looks like a really cosy family room. The ceilings are really high, but it's no less cosy because of that, really.
So the current owners have refurbished it since they bought it 4 years ago.
Okay.
Let me show you what they've added.
The property has two double bedrooms, a dressing area and a bathroom, which are all modern extensions on the original 18th century structure.
Oh, wow.
It's huge.
It is massive.
It's really a good size master.
Really, yeah. Very good size master bedroom.
How do you feel about one level living?
It's not something I would say no to. Not a problem with it at all.
Well, the main thing with this mystery house was the land, wasn't it?
Mm.
Should we go and have a look at more of it?
Yes, yeah. Please.
In addition to the 2 acres that come with this property, it has its own garage, a shed, and even a static caravan.
So here we are. All this could be yours. Is it too much? Is it overwhelming?
I wonder if it might be a little bit overwhelming. I'm not sure if it would be a little too much.
Mm. What do you think, Victoria?
It is a lot of space. And, yeah, what would you do with it all?
You'd let the sheep roam around?
You'd let the sheep roam around.
You would.
Maybe the price will help.
I'm going to let Victoria start this time.
I'm going to go 285.
I definitely don't think it's lower, so I'm going to say 290.
It's on the market for £279,950.
Wow.
Wow.
OK, again, surprising.
Mm.
I'm really surprised with what you get for that.
Well, there's lots to explore here, isn't there?
There is.
2 acres.
Absolutely.
Be my guest.
Okay.
And come and find me.
Thank you.
Although the priciest of our lineup, our 18th century mystery cottage still rings in some £15,000 under budget. It's chock full of charming living space, has two bedrooms, and boasts the best of North Wales with mountain, countryside, and coastal views. So could this landscape tempt Julia a little further away from Victoria?
The land surrounding the mystery house is amazing, completely not what I was expecting at all. The property itself is really, really nice. Somewhere I could see Mum living.
The house itself, there's nothing I don't like about it. It's amazing, that superb fireplace. It's a beautiful house.
it feels a little more remote. I think perhaps because it's on a hillside, and I'm wondering if I might feel a little bit more lonely perhaps here by myself.
It would be completely different to her lifestyle now, absolutely. Just one end of the spectrum to the other, I think. Well, this is what she signed up for, so, you know, this would really be escaping to the country, which is what she asked for.
Have you made a decision yet?
Nearly, I think so.
Nearly? Let's get some tea, I want to find out.
Although it's an integral part of North Wales's architectural landscape, Slate has also been the backbone for the local economy since the 1700s. But it wasn't until the mid-19th century that the industry boomed, completely transforming the geography and life in the region. In the 1870s, the town of Blaenau Ffestiniog was home to over 18,000 slate miners, who were each producing around 600 slates a day. When the mines closed in the 20th century, many moved away, and the area was left a ghost town. But today, over 50 years since the last mine was closed, Blaenau Ffestiniog has a new lease of life, brought about by, of all things, a zip wire. I'm meeting the manager of Zip World, Ian Nichols, to find out how adventure tourism is regenerating this area.
Ian, you've got quite a setup here, a real mix of the old industry that this part of the world was known for, mining, with adventure, which is what Wales is really starting to become known for.
Yeah, it's a massive combination of the old and the new. So we've taken part of the old disused industry and turned into a fantastic, adventurous place for excitement and fun.
And one of the key points is it's created jobs in an area that had been struggling because of the shutting down of lots of the mining industry.
Blaenau Ffestiniog was really struggling with young people moving away from the local area. But now that's all changed, and North Wales now attracts people and tourism, and the population are booming now. I mean, we still have some of the mining families still work here, so they've gone from working in the quarries to actually, you know, bringing new people in and telling people about the local area and about the history as well. The quarries are all up in the mountains there, and we'll have a drive up to the top and you'll be able to see the vast expanse of the quarries that we've got here.
Let's get on the road.
Huge piles of slate that dominate this landscape are the spoils from a century of mining. For every tonne of slate that was produced, there were 9 tonnes of waste left behind, incorporated into the landscape.
So you can see the spectacular views looking over Snowdonia.
What a view from up here.
Yeah. Spectacular, isn't it?
I was going to ask, how many mines are we seeing here?
Well, we can see 4 from where we're stood. The Manod Quarry, Minor Ferrin, Oakley Quarry and Llechwedd all in this area. And they say North Wales roofed the world, and every part of the process started and finished here, from excavating the stone to splitting it perfectly and dressing it and then sending it off on the Ffestiniog Railway around the world.
When you get tourists here, how much do they ask about the history of the place?
They're fascinated. What we try and do is blend our activities with the history of the site and the history of Snowdonia.
The slate industry literally shaped the local landscape, so it's wonderful that its heritage still plays a significant role in its new incarnation.
It looks like a seat.
Yes, so you're going to put on like a jacket.
OK.
Around there. Watch your head. I'm just going to pass these over the top of your head.
OK.
OK.
By opening up the quarries as an adventure site, 200 new jobs have been created. And with tourists staying in the area, local hotels and restaurants also reap the benefits of the tourism boom.
You come and stand underneath the wire for me.
And how fast will it go?
It'll go 40 to 50 miles an hour.
OK.
And then slow down at the bottom.
All kitted up, it's my turn to enjoy the very best view in the valley.
Ready?
Yeah, absolutely.
OK. 3, 2, 1, go.
Let's do this.
Thank you.
And it's such a wonderful way to see this landscape. It's stunning. Can I go again? Julia's liked all three of the properties we've shown her, but she's dropped some pretty strong hints about which one is her favourite. Time to find out if she's ready to make the move. This looks lovely. So, after the mystery house, you'd nearly made a decision.
Yes.
Are we there yet?
I think so. The houses all had amazing things to offer. But with house two and house three, I didn't get the same feeling as I did in house one. And it just felt right. The right size house, for one, the right amount of garden and land around me. Obviously, having a choice, I think you go for the one which really calls to you, which really makes you feel at home.
And Victoria, we could see Julia feel at home in house number one, couldn't we?
Yeah, definitely. It's not surprised me at all that she's gone with one.
And the main thing is location, isn't it?
Yes.
House number two wasn't rural enough. The mystery house was too rural in many ways. Mm. And house number one, just right.
I mean, it's halfway between Victoria and the Menai Straits. I can, you know, they're both just 15 minutes away either direction.
And let's not forget, house number one was hugely under budget.
Being under budget gives me more opportunity to just sit and think about what I want to do in terms of working or study. It's nice to have that buffer.
And I think even if it was near the top end of her budget, I still think she'd have gone for number one.
So what happens next? What's the next step?
I shall definitely be asking to go and look at house number one again.
So Wales definitely feels like home?
Yes. Yes.
Well, the very best of luck.
Thank you.
I hope the second viewing of house number one goes well.
I'm sure it will.
And will you let me know how it goes?
Definitely. Definitely. We'll keep in touch. Thank you.
Well, that is one very happy house buyer. Julia was positive about all three of the properties we showed her, but it soon became clear that house number one was the one. Victoria was, of course, her mum's main draw to this part of the country, and I don't think it'll be long before Julia makes North Wales her home too. We wish them both the very best. See you next time on Escape to the Country.
If you'd like to escape to the country in Wales, Northern Ireland, Scotland or England and would like our help, why not apply online at bbc.co.uk/beonashow.